Done. Good Friday commemorates the crucifixion of Jesus Christ and his death for the salvation of the whole world. Death was not the end, but was to redeem all those who believed in Jesus Christ. Those who believed would be saved. The purpose of Jesus Christ to come in this world was not to live but to die. As we all come into this world, we come to live. Jesus Christ came to do the will of his heavenly Father. As John 3:16 it is written in the Bible, God so loved the world that he sent his only beloved Son to save the world.
So today is Good Friday, a day all Catholics all over the world look forward to. It is the culmination of a 40-day period of prayer and fasting and penance that we call Lent. With Good Friday, we commemorate the sufferings, death and resurrection of Jesus, that resurrection which will be celebrated on Easter Sunday. Good Friday is the climax, so to say, but it's not the end of everything. After Jesus died, he also rose from the dead. And if Jesus had not risen from the dead, then all this suffering and death would be of no use. So this morning we had the way of the cross with a lot of people participating when we had it on the playground. There we contemplated the passion and death of Jesus. But now we are about to begin this service of the celebration of the Lord's Passion. It consists of four parts. The first part is just the Word of God, where we'll have the Passion sung. And then there will be the intercessions. Through the precious blood of Jesus, we make intercessions for all peoples, of all nations, of all cultures, people of all categories. No one is excluded from our prayers, because no one is excluded from the blood of Jesus. Then we will have the veneration of the cross, which is an integral part of today's service. Since we are allowed to have only one cross, we have a huge cross with about 8 lines going to it, and we are able to accommodate these 5,000, 6,000 people who are here assembled on our grounds. And the service, this veneration itself takes about 45 minutes or so. Then on Good Friday, we do not have the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, but we have just the distribution of Holy Communion. The Holy Communion that was consecrated at yesterday's Mass, the Mass of the Last Supper, is kept for today. And so there is just a simple ceremony of the distribution of Holy Communion. Many people are very enthusiastic about this service. It's a very somber service, simple service, but it's a very touching service because it affects our very sentiments. We all suffer, isn't it? All of us have some pain, and all of us one day will have to die. But death is not the end of everything. With Christ, we will also rise again. And in our difficulties and in our problems, we realize that these are all temporary, because Christ comes to be our companion, our comfort and our consolation. Once this service is over, which will take about 2 hours, 2.5 hours, we will get ready for tomorrow's Easter Vigil, when we will commemorate the rising of Jesus from the dead.
Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Safran will invest to start a helicopter maintenance, repair and overall facilities in Goa. The companies will acquire land assets from the state-owned company Goa Auto Accessories Limited. Speaking to media persons, EDC Chairman Siddharth Kunkolkar said that this project will benefit in terms of employment generation in the state.
First, for planning, amchi Goa Auto Accessories Limited, mune GAPL company ami keli, joint venture. आणि कालांतरानं ती हळूहळू टेक्नॉलॉजीक लागून कामाक लागून मागीर बंद पडली. त्यानंतर EDC ने एक डिसिजन घेतलें की ती कंपनी एक बऱ्या कामाक जर वापरपाक मेळटा, आनी खंयचोय थंय जर धंदो उबारपाक मेळटा आनी कोणाक रोजगारी मेळटलो, गोवर्मेंटाक टॅक्स मेळटलो, आणि अशी जर कोणी खंयची गव्हर्मेंटाची संस्था जर करता जाल्यार आमी ते गव्हर्मेंटाक विकपाक आमची तयारी आशिल्ली. आणि ताज्या अंतर्गत त्यांनाचे आदले आमचे रक्षामंत्री मनोहरभाई पर्रीकर हाणें आमकां मदत करून हिंदुस्तान एरोनॉटिक्स लिमिटेड आणि साफ्रान म्हणून हाजें जॉयंट वेंचर चलतालें आसा फॉर हॅलिकॉप्टर इंजीन रिपेर्स ओवरऑलिंग फेसिलिटी. कित्याक आयज डिफेन्सा कडेकच जवळ जवळ 600-700 हॅलिकॉप्टरां आसा आनी तांची 10% इंजिन्स आर ऑलवेज अंडर ओवरऑल रिपेर्स, इट इज मँडेटरी. सो ताका लागून एक गरज आशिल्ली इन्स्टेड ऑफ सेंडींग द हॅलिकॉप्टर्स आउटसायड इंडिया फ्रांसाक धाडटाले ते पयलीं हॅलिकॉप्टर ओवरऑल करपाक मेनटेन करपाक. आनी ताका लागून मेड इन इंडिया जे मेक इन इंडिया जे पॉलिसी खाला ही एच ए एल साफ्रानाची कंपनीन आमचे EDC कडल्यान ती GFL कंपनी ती घेतली. थंय आतां पयर IDC सगळे सोपस्कार पूर्ण जाल्या. हालींच पयर गेल्या म्हयन्याक तांचे नांवाचेरय ती ट्रान्सफर जाली, दे पेड EDC फुल्ली. आनी पयर आमची एक इनफॉर्मल मिटींग तांच्या एच ए एल आनी सेफ्रन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्हा बरोबर जाल्या. आतां ते हांगा प्रोडक्शनूय चालू करपाक सोदता आनी ताका लागून जे तांचे कितें स्टेच्युटरी परमिशन्स आसा, रिक्वायरमेंट्स आसा, ते आमी EDC तांकां अनऑफिशियली हेल्पूय करता, मदत करता एट गव्हर्मेंट लेवल टू एक्सपेडायट देअर प्रोसेसीस सो दॅट एक्च्युली समथींग सम प्रोडक्टीव वर्क स्टार्ट्स. आतां ते म्हाका दिसता रिक्रुटमेंटूय चालू करतले बिकॉज कोण घेता तांकां ट्रेनिंगाकय धाडचे पडटले, 3-4 म्हयने ट्रेनींग आसतले तें. सो तें करतकीर बिकॉज स्पेशल व्हेरी स्पेशलायज्ड जॉब.
Minister for Law and Judiciary Francis D'Souza said that even though the government has enacted the Goa Abolition and Proprietorship Titles and Act 2014 for finding a solution to the Mayem Evacue property, the matter is in the court and hence could take some time to get sorted out.
Concern me pun thoda gosht kare ata ek transfer mhanje majo common gate jo lokanche gele ek Mayem Evacue property jo vishay to court an hapay to sapan ajani
okay
तो विषय पळोवपाक जाय खंय पावला पळय तो, पूण एक्च्युली तो रेवेन्यू सब्जेक्ट म्हणटा ते कोटा ना म्हणून ते म्हजे कडेन येयला लॉ मिनिस्टरा कडेन.
ओके,
चौकशी करीत खंय पावला, कित्याक उरला पळय तें. आनी दुसरें कितें जालां, तेका प्रोविजनल पोजिशन दी म्हण सांगणार आनी तेजो थोडे हॅरेसमेंट चलता म्हण सांगता ते. म्हणटा आय वील बी टेकिंग ए जॉयंट मिटींग ऑफ द रेवेन्यू मिनिस्टर, कित्याक तेजो इन्चार्ज तो एवॅक्यू प्रॉपर्टी रेवेन्यू मिनिस्टर इन्चार्ज. मागीर एजी गापोवचो पडटलो आनी कहो विशय सोडोवपाक गावता पळय तो.
हॅरेसमेंट बाय हूम?
बाय आंतोनियो पिरेरा म्हणून.
ओके,
तो ओनर, तो एक को ओनर आसता म्हाका.
Bharatiya Yuva Morcha condemned the allegations made by the state unit of National Students Union of India, ERAS Mulla, that mining engineering students passing out from college were unable to get employment. Speaking to media persons, the president of Bharatiya Yuva Morcha, Urvesh Redkar, claimed that 90% of the students are already employed and only 10% are unemployed. He also condemned the NSUI for asking the chief minister to quit the post for his failure to provide alternative employment opportunities to the mining students after the closure of mining activities in the state.
Don this pahili NSUI cha headan, Ehraz Mulla, an ek statement kello. की आमचे गोंय राज्याचे मुखेलमंत्री श्री मनोहरभाई पर्रीकरान राजिनामा दिवचो. समज ऑल्टरनेटिव्स जे मायनींग बंद जाला, जे लोक जे भुरग्यांचे करियराचेर तेणी एक ऑल्टरनेटिव दिवचे, हेजेर आमी पूर्णपणे निशेध करता. आनी हें सांगूंक सोदता की तेणी जे फॅक्ट्स सांगल्या आनी आमचे स्टेटमेंट्स केल्या ते सगळे चुकीचे आसा.
जे स्टेटमेंट केल्यात म्हणजेच पहिले तेणे म्हटलं की 70 स्टुडंट्स म्हणजे गोवा इंजिनियरिंग कॉलेज जी आसा आमची तितूंतल्यान बी इन मायनींग म्हणजे बॅचलर्स ऑफ इंजिनियरिंग मायनींग डिपार्टमेंटांतल्यान 70 स्टुडंट्स पास आउट जाता एवरी इयर. वो जो डेटा तेणे दिला तो टोटल फॉल्स आसा. एक्च्युली एक बॅचींतल्यान फक्त 30 स्टुडंट्सूच पास आउट जाता एवरी इयर आनी मॅक्झिमम कॅपेसिटी जी आसा म्हणजे ऑन प्रॉस्पेक्टस जो डेटा दिल्लो आसा गोवा इंजिनियरिंग कॉलेजीचो तितून भितर 34 स्टुडंट्सूच आसा फॉर मायनींग स्टुडंट्स. हो जालो पयलो पॉयंट. तसोच सेकेंड पॉयंट तेणें म्हटलां की एकूय जॉब मेळूंक ना 2017 जे पास आउट जाले बॅचीक तो वॉय डेटा टोटल फॉल्स आसा. 2016-17 जी बॅच पास आउट जाल्ली तातूंत भितरले ऑलरेडी 9-10 भुरगे हे प्लेसमेंट तांकां प्लेसमेंट मेळिल्लो आसा आनी ऑल टुगेदर 29 स्टुडंट्स आशिल्ले 2016-17 बॅचीन आनी थोड्यांक प्लेसमेंटाच्यो ऑफर्स आयल्ल्यो बट मायनींग बॅन जाल्ल्या कारणान तेंचे प्लेसमेंट जे आसा ते कांयशा प्रमाणान स्थगीत जाल्ले आसा. बट गोवा गोवर्मेंटाचेर निश्चितूच तोडगो काडटले आनी जे इंजिनियरींग कॉलेजीचे ऑथॉरिटीज आसात जे प्लेसमेंटाचे बाबतीन पळयतात तेंच्यांनी ऑलरेडी गोंया भायर वचून तेजेर सोल्युशन काडपाचो प्रयत्न केल्लो आसा. म्हणजे गोंया भायर ज्यो मायनींग कंपनीज आसात तेंचे कडेन उलोवप तेंचे चालू आसा. सो निश्चितूच हे जे दोन थोडे भुरगे उरलेले आसात तेंकां प्लेसमेंट मेळटलो. तशेंच आनीक तेणेन पॉयंट म्हटला की लास्ट 3 इयर्स म्हणजे तिनूच बॅची पास आउट जाल्ल्यो आसा आजून पर्यंत मायनींग डिपार्टमेंट स्टार्ट जाल्ल्यान गोवा युनिवर्सिटीन. तितून भितरले ओन्ली 10% यू म्हणजे मायनींग इंजिनियर्स जे आसात ते एम्प्लॉयड जाला अशें तेणें म्हटलां. बट एक्चुली वॉय डेटा जो आसा तो फॉल्स. एक्चुली फक्त 10% जे इंजिनियर्स आसात ते उरलेले आसा तेंकां प्लेसमेंट मेळपाक आनी ऑलरेडी 90% मायनींग इंजिनियर्स जे आसात तेंकां ऑलरेडी प्लेसमेंट मेळिल्लो आसा. आनी फस्ट 2 बॅची ज्यो जाल्ल्यो तितूंतले टोटल फस्ट बॅचीक 31 आनी सेकेंड बॅचीक 30 सो ऑल टुगेदर 61 मायनींग इंजिनियर्स जे आशिल्ले तेंकां ऑलरेडी प्लेसमेंट मेळिल्लो आसा. फॉर प्लेसमेंट तेंकां मायनींग कंपनीज लायक वेदांता फॉमेंतो आनी ऑलरेडी गोंया भायर आनी इंडिये भायरूय तेंकां प्लेसमेंट मेळिल्लो आसा. फोर्थ पॉयंट जो मेजर पॉयंट्स आसा तो 30 स्टुडंट्स डुईंग एमए इन गोवा इंजिनियरींग कॉलेज. 300 स्टुडंट्स डुईंग एमए इन गोवा इंजिनियरींग कॉलेज. वॉय फॉल्स एक्चुली फक्त 134 स्टुडंट्स सेकेंड इयर एमए म्हणटा 134 स्टुडंट्स सेकेंड इयर एमए करता आनी जर फस्ट इयर आनी सेकेंड इयर दोनी डेटा जर काउंट करीत जाल्यार इट कम्स टू हार्डली 230 स्टुडंट्स नॉट ओन्ली 300 बट हार्डली 230 स्टुडंट्स येता. सो आनी तेणें आनी एक पॉयंट म्हटला की एमए इन मायनींग एक्चुली गोवा युनिवर्सिटी एमए इन मायनींग दिना फक्त बी इन मायनींग हो कोर्स ऑफर करता. एमए इन जर मायनींग करतलो जाल्यार आयदर द स्टुडंट हॅज टू टेक एडमिशन आउटसायड द स्टेट ऑर आउटसायड द कंट्री. बी कोर्स जो आसा तो 2011-12 ह्या वर्सा स्टार्ट जाल्लो मायनिंगान आनी तेज्या नंतर 2015-16 2016-17 2017-18 अश्यो 3 बॅची बी इन पास आउट जाल्ले आसा आनी तितून भितरले 90% इंजिनियर्सांक ऑलरेडी जॉब ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज मेळिल्ल्यो आसा. आनी मेन थींग करंट बॅच जे आसा म्हणजे 17-18 बॅच आसा तितून भितरले ऑलरेडी दोग जाण स्टुडंट्स जे आसा तेंकां ऑलरेडी प्लेसमेंट मेळिल्लो आसा आनी बाकीचे जे स्टुडंट्स आसा तेंकां प्लेसमेंट्साच्यो जॉब फेअर किंवां आनी खंयच्याय प्रोग्रामांतल्यान गोवर्मेंट एज वेल एज मायनींग डिपार्टमेंट गोवा इंजिनियरींग कॉलेजीचे तेंकां जॉब ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज मेळपाक ट्राय करीत आसात. आनी मेन थींग मायनींग डिपार्टमेंटाच्या प्लेसमेंटाच्या बाबतीन तेणें आनी एक हें केलो की विदीन द स्टेट ऑफ गोवा तेंकां मायनींग क्षेत्रांत तेंकां जॉब ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज मेळना. बट फॅक्ट इज दॅट जे मायनींग स्टुडंट्स आसात तेंकां ऑलरेडी ट्रेनींग जी तेंची आसता ती गोंयांत जायना ती गोंया भायर जाता आयदर इन द स्टेट्स ऑफ जम्मू काश्मीर सॉरी झारखंड ओडिसा जे मायनींग रिलेटेड ज्यो स्टेट्स आसात त्या स्टेटींनी जाता. सो हांव अशें म्हणटा की आमच्या कॉन्स्टिट्युशनान सुद्दां असो एमेंडमेंट केल्लो आसा की जेन्ना तूं इंडियन सिटीजन आसता सो यू कॅन टेक अप जॉब एनीवेर इन द कंट्री. सो आमचे जे मायनींग इंजिनियर्स आसात तेंकां गोंयानूच मायनींग ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज जर नाका तर तेंच्यांनी गोंया भायर म्हणजे मायनींग रिलेटेड स्टेट्स ज्यो आसात झारखंड ओडिसा आतां म्हटल्या प्रमाणे त्या स्टेटींनी वचूं येता. अदरवायज गोंया भायरूय म्हणजे सावथ आफ्रिका धर किंवां आनीक ज्यो कंट्रीज आसा मायनींग थंय मोठ्या प्रमाणांत चलता थंय तेंच्यांनी जॉब ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज घेवपाक मेळटा. आनी गोवान जो स्टुडंट आसता इज अ एसेट आउटसायड इंडिया बिकॉज गोवन स्टुडंट जो आसता तो ऑटोमॅटिकली वेल क्वॉलिफायड आसता बिकॉज आमचे जे संस्कार जाता ल्हानपणाच्यानूच ते खूब बऱ्या प्रमाणांत आसता. सो आमची जी उलोवपाची स्टायल आसता आनी आमची वॉकॅबलरी किंवां आनीक आमचे वागपाचे वागपाचे जे स्टायल आसा ती कंप्लिटली डिफरंट आसता. सो गोवन स्टुडंट इज अ एसेट to outside states.
Nearly 200 private unaided schools across the state will remain closed on 7th April as the All Goa Government Recognized Unaided Schools Association has decided to support the national movement called by the National Independent Schools Alliance Delhi demanding reforms in education. The association has decided to hold a peaceful rally where stakeholders will come from Mapsa and Margao to Panjim.
On the 7th of April, National Independent Schools Association of India, of which we, the Goa, also is a member, is going to...
Alliance.
Yeah, National Independent Schools Alliance. We are a member of this National Independent Schools Alliance. And we are also going to join in a very big rally, which they are going to have in Delhi at Ram Leela Maidan. And we would like the main agenda of that meeting at Ram Leela Maidan is that they would like to present a charter to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. The charter is about, you know, the right to education 2009, wherein they have very clearly said that the infrastructure is the base recognition for the you know norms rakha hai ki infrastructure should be the recognition norms, but what we would like to say is it should be learning based outcomes, you know, the recognition to schools should be learning based. And the second thing was there is again we need to have an equality wherein a voucher system to be given to every child which will benefit the parent as well, and it will also a 2500 rupees voucher should be given maybe to a child per month so that the child and the parent can decide in which school they can go to. So this is one more thing that we would like to the charter is saying. The third thing that the charter is also saying is that, you know, these days if you hear the news, and all of y'all are in the news you know, the thing that you'll write, but what we have seen is there has been a lot of problems with, you know, children removing guns at school and shooting the teachers, or a bus topples down and a principal is put behind bars for three months. So this should not be happening. So we would like that the charter says that let us have a very good security measure, not only for the students, but for the management, for the teachers and for the principal as well. So there should be a proper guidelines to be, and this reform policies should be taken up by the whole. It should be a central reform policy which will bring about a very good change for India as such. So these are the charters that we are trying to put it together at the Ram Leela Maidan. And what we hear in Goa we are very fortunate. आमका अशें दिसता की आमी खूपच लकी आसात की आमच्या गोवा गव्हर्मेंट इज नॉट ट्रबलिंग अस ऑर हॅरसिंग अस. इन फॅक्ट वी आर व्हेरी लकी दॅट गोवा गव्हर्मेंट इज विथ अस अँड दे आर गिविंग अस यू नो गुड रिस्पेक्ट, अँड वी आर ऑल्सो इन्वायटेड टू देअर फंक्शन्स इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एड्युकेशन. वी आर गिवन इक्वल राईट्स, सो वी आर अ लिटल बिट हॅपी विथ दॅम विथ वॉट वी आर फेसिंग विथ आवर गव्हर्मेंट. बट इन अदर स्टेट्स देर आर लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. Schools are being closed down due to these norms and not recognition being given to them due to the infrastructure problems. So the states want to come together and work on this. What we want to tell you is on this 7th of April, which is again we are just doing a solidarity with the NISA to show our solidarity towards NISA. What we are doing is
We are members of NISA,
okay, and we want to show our solidarity. So we are going to have a silent and a peaceful car rally on the 7th of April, car and bikes, yes. And the car and bikes will be moving from two directions, one which is from Margao side, Vasco side, and the other is from Mapsa side. And all the schools, yeah, from Ponda also, the schools are joining in. All the unaided schools will be participating in this rally on the cars and bikes.
And schools will remain closed.
And the schools, we will be keeping it closed on the 7th of April, just to show the solidarity so that the reforms are made together for the benefit of every child, every parent and everybody. It is not for any particular reason, but it is for everybody to just have equal justice. So this rally will come together at Panjim.
Are you searching for a platform to promote your business? At Don Bosco channel, you can achieve milestone. Contact us